Lord God, we pray to have our eyes opened up, to have our lives opened up, to see the truth revealed, to see your day of glory, Lord. Most of all, Lord, we pray that Jesus might stretch out his hand upon the world and heal our hurts. The eternal love that pours out from him, that flows from his wounds, that shines from his truth, that sets a light upon our path, that it might rain down on us as your glory is celebrated among your people. Lord, the houses of worship are empty, but the homes that have never come together in faith are drawing together today. And today the house of worship is the whole world. People who are seeking answers are looking to you, Lord. Lord, hear your children today who have never spoken to you in prayer, who are discovering that their Lord and Maker and Master of all the cosmos has named them a child and wants to hear their voice. Lord, give them the words to speak, O Lord, and grant them mercy, grant them peace. Lord, commission us again to go forth into the world with your word of truth upon our lips and evidenced in our actions. Lord, empower us to manifest your grace, your peace, your love in all that we say and do. And Lord, we thank you for the witness of the people who are working through this crisis. Dedicated healthcare workers, nurses, doctors, but Lord, I especially want to lift before you the people who clean. Lord, those who with mop and cloth and spray and cleaner are touching what we all fear. Lord, grant them your protection and bless them for their courage. Lord, be with everyone who keeps a supply of food and necessities to warehouses and stores, moving and vibrant. Lord, we consider those who are helping us weather some of the stress of this, those who are looking to our needs. Lord, we thank you for their presence, the calls we are receiving, and the way that we are able to look out for one another. And Lord, we pray, rejoicing that we still have our daily bread. Lord, we give thanks for those who are at work making this possible. Lord, we pray for parents and we pray for children. Lord, we pray for the home dynamics that must be confusing for children and challenging for parents. May this be a time when family relationships flourish, are rejoined or strengthened, and everyone learns to be better families. But Lord, we recognize and we know that there are dysfunctional families right now, families and households where abuse exists and where children are now and youth are trapped in these situations. And Lord, we pray for eyes to see and for us to be awakened, for them to not feel trapped, to reach out for help. And Lord, the help is there. Lord, that they will be relieved from these fears, that help will come, that transformation will take place, that transition as it needs to happen will happen. And Lord, that these youth will be raised in happy homes and homes that are broken can be healed and mended and, Lord, brought to be a whole people, a whole family before you again. Lord, we pray for the miracles that need to happen in order for that to be possible. Lord, we pray for our seniors, those who go before us in so much of life and who have wisdom and experience. Lord, we ask, even as they feel so vulnerable in the midst of this crisis, that we will support and surround them and encourage them in our communities, that we will continue to respect them, Lord, and to be guided by their wisdom and experience. Lord, help us to show the best sign of who we are as your church and as your people as we go forward in this together. Lord, though we are distant from each other, let us not become separate or ignorant of one another, but help us to love and to care for our neighbor through this, to be there in times of trouble, to intercede when and where you call us to be. Lord, we pray for our leaders. We pray for our nation's leader and his household, and that this illness is there. And Lord, that he is coping and they are coping together to see a way through this. Lord, that they set an example of that leadership. We pray for all those in our society who, in their positions of leadership, feel vulnerable and feel isolated, and that they must make decisions for us all in some of those terrible and difficult decisions. Lord, we pray also, as we consider the needs of our region, for this coming spring, for this time of thaw. And we know, Lord, that the threats of flood and other troubles that come with the fall, the weakening of roads, are things that our leaders must consider. Lord, help us to be respectful, to use the resources that we have been given well. Let us be mindful of those who respond at all times to uplift us in our needs. And Lord, we pray for places in the world that are struggling with this pandemic. We pray for Italy and its ongoing difficulties. Lord, more than difficulties. The terrible hardships, the cataclysm of this illness that has hit them in Italy. We also pray for China and Korea as they now see what is seeming a recovery, that that may continue, that they may give us a good example to follow. Lord, we pray that we must learn from each other, seek answers together to bring healing and hope to a world that needs it now so badly. Lord, we pray and thanks for those who continue to serve and to protect, who stand guard, to maintain safety and sensibility in a very trying time. Be their source of peace and help us to endure, to preserve and to continue to care. Finally, Lord, we pray for those concerns that are always there, that existed before any of this trouble began. Lord, grant us eyes to see, hearts to care, minds to consider, and faith to love our neighbor. In Christ we pray. Amen.